in this semester also we will talk about another classification of Arabic nouns. We divide them into rational and irrational. In Arabic we say aqil and ghair zawir uqul. Okay? For human beings we call it zawil uqul, and you know, objects, non-living things, this is called ghair zawil uqul. Even the animals also ghair zawil uqul. So what is the grammatical difference between these two? We also will talk about and elaborate on the concept of dual in Arabic. Unlike English or Urdu or other languages where the plural starts right after one. If these are two books, it's a plural in English. Then you say books, two books. This is not the case in Arabic. With number two is not the plural. Arabic plural starts from number three. If there are three books, then you say plural. For two, we have another word that is called musanna or tasniya. Musanna or tasniya, dual. So what is the concept of dual in Arabic? And we follow it, you know, in the verbs. If you are saying that two women, two sisters, you have a different word. If you say two men, you have different words. I give you the example of the noun also, two books, two pen, two cars. So inshallah it will be a new information for you. Then we also will cover Arabic numerals 3 to 10. Although we learned from 1 to 10 in the last semester, but this time we are talking about grammatical, their, you know, sequence. The grammar is that from 3 to 10, if the object that you are counting, if it is a male word, we bring the Arabic number female. We go against, opposite. Because Arabic numbers also, they have gender. Like Salas is three. So Salas is male word. Salasah, when you add Ta Marbuta, it becomes female number. Okay? So, this Salas and Salasa, I am writing, for example, this is Salasa with Ta Marbuta is a feminine number because it has Ta Marbuta, and we already learned Ta Marbuta, right? Without Ta Marbuta, this is male. Okay. But it is very interesting that in Arabic, when we want to say the thing that we are describing with three, either you say three tables, three chairs, three cars, or maybe you can say three men, three women. Okay. So we will look at the gender of the object. If we are saying three tables, and what is the word for table in Arabic? Tawila. Tawila. So tawila is male or female?
Female,
because it has ta marbuta. So if you want to say three tables, you will use the male word for that. Okay? However, if you want to say three men, and what is the word for men in Arabic?
Rajul.
Rajul and Jama?
Rijal.
Rijal. So if you say three men, that is plural, you say
Salasa Rijal.
Salasa Rijal. You will bring feminine number for the male. Yes. So this is a very interesting in Arabic. So Salasa Rijal. And let me write the word for women. Salasu Nisa. Nisa is women. So it always goes opposite from 3 to 9. 3 to 9. So we will learn this grammar. Is it interesting, right? Okay. Then, last our lesson will be about a topic that is known as Al-Mamnu' Min As-Sarf. Al-Mamnu' Min As-Sarf. What does it mean? There are a groups of nouns. There are 9 types of nouns. They do not take tanween or kasra. There is no kasra or tanween you can put on those nouns. Okay. For example, the name Ahmad. The name Ahmad. It is the name of our Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam also, and the common Muslim name. So this is one of those categories from those 9 type of nouns. We cannot bring kasra on the name of Ahmad. Okay, you know, whenever the changes will be according to the grammar, and you know the changes take place. Either Ahmad is a subject or object, or again the position, or maybe you have a preposition before the name Ahmad, right? So if you have preposition like harf jar, do you remember harf jar? So what is the effect of harf jar?
Kasra.
It gives kasra to the following noun, but there will be no effect of harf jar in the name of Ahmad.
Okay.
However, for example, if you have Hadal Kitab Li Ahmad, this book belongs to Ahmad, right? So you will say Li, right? You add Lam Kasra, and Lam is preposition. So according to the grammar, it should be Ahmadi, right? Because if you say Brother Tanveer, so you will say Litanveer, Hadal Kitab Litanveerin, right? Kasra. But we are not allowed to bring either Kasra or either Tanveen also. We cannot bring Tanveen on Dawat Ahmad. Okay. So how we will use with Li? With Fatha. We will put the Fatha. We will say Li Ahmada. So this is one example. The other example, all the names of the female, Maryam, Zainab, Aisha, Khadija, Khalida, all they belong to this same category. We will not bring Kasra or Tanween in those names. Okay, we will say Li Maryama, Li Zainaba, Li Fatimata, Li Aishata. So, this is very interesting. These are 9 types of nouns. They are known as mamnu min as-sarf. They do not take kasra and tanween. At this point, just remember that. So, this is, I give you a synopsis for the whole semester, inshallah, grammatical wise. And then you will be loaded with so many verbs and the conjugations and the new vocabulary and drills, exercises. And then inshallah we will cover from this book also for our Fusha Arabic, standard Arabic, and some parts of the grammar you will see in this book also. And then you have your speaking conversational Arabic exercise that we spend 20 minutes. So alhamdulillah, I'm done with that. Now we want to go quickly in few minutes all those lessons from 1 to 10, that what did we learn, right? And if we just look at the English part, that is enough, because that English part gives us the rules and the practical application in the Arabic side. So we are not going to application, just the rules. And then I encourage you that everyone should tell us, for example, Brother Tanveer, what did we learn in lesson number 1? And you all go on page number 1 in this Medina book.
So lesson 1 we learned about Hada and
yes.
Which is this, right?
We just learned about Hada. That means this, right? Okay. After that, we also learned for feminine, because hada, this for male. What was the word for feminine?
Hadi.
Hadi. Very good. Okay. Then lesson number two. Brother Omar, what did we learn?
Lesson number two. We studied zalik.
Yes. Zalika.
Zalika.
That means?
That is.
Yes. Zalika means that. So hada this, zalika that. What was the feminine for zalika?
Tilka.
Tilka. Very good. MashaAllah. Okay. And then go lesson number three. Brother Hassan, what did we learn in lesson number three?
Number three, we said definite article and indefinite article.
Yes, very good. Definite article, what is that definite article in Arabic?
Al.
Very good. And if you do not have al, instead you have tanween at the end. So you define it as indefinite. Okay? So without al and with the tanween is indefinite. And with al is definite. But this is not 100%. There are exceptions. You will find some names, they have tanween and they do not have al, but still they are definite because they are the names of like a proper name. For example, Khalid, the name of Khalid. You can say Khalidun. Khalidun. So you are using with tanween and there is no al, but that is definite because this is the name of a particular person. Yes. Okay, then in the same lesson we also learned about Shamsi letters and Qamari letters. Do you remember?
Yes.
Moon letters and sun letters. So, sister, what happens, what is the difference between Shamsi and Qamari letters?
There is a Shadda to the end.
In what?
In the beginning, Al-Najm becomes Al-Najm.
So, in Shamsi letters, when we put Alif Lam, so Lam merges
with
the next letter, following letter. And for this assimilation, to indicate this assimilation, we put the Shadda. Like she gave the example, An-Najm. So An-Najm originally was Al-Najm. But Lam merged into Noon, and then we put the Shadda on Noon. That is, we do with all Shamsi letters. In Qamari letters, however, Lam it remains. We write Lam, we pronounce Lam. Yes, sister, can you give me an example of Qamari letter?
Al-Qahwa.
Very good, mashallah. Al-Qahwa. Very good. Or Al-Qamar.
Al-Qamar.
Al-Kitab. So these are all Qamari letters. Very good. Then we should go next. Lesson number four. Brother Babar, what did we learn?
We learned to use the preposition.
Yes. What is the preposition? How do you define it? And what is the function or effect of preposition? Okay.
The preposition makes the noun majrur.
Yes, that's it. Yes. Normal ending, if there is no preposition before a noun,
it's
a normal ending is with Dhamma always.
Okay?
You say Baytun. Or if you put Alif Lam, you say Al-Baytu. Right? But whenever you bring a preposition, for example, Fi. So then you say Fi Baytin. So Baytun became Baytin. Fi Baytin. Or if you add Fi with Al-Bayt, so it became fil baiti. Yes. From al baitu fil baiti. Yeah. So we learned about this preposition. Okay. Another preposition is ala, like on the desk. So you say alal maktabi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Fatiha, Alhamdu lillahi. Right? So lillahi we recite kasra because of li. Li is preposition. So we, over there we cannot say lillahu. We cannot say lillaha. Then, what is the next information, sister? We learned in lesson number 4, after this preposition.
Huwa he and huwa she.
Very good, mashallah. So, how do you define grammatical names? Grammatical names of huwa and here?
Either a human being, a person, or animal.
Pronoun, right. So, huwa is a pronoun, here is pronoun. So, huwa is for masculine and here is for feminine. Okay, here is another interesting thing. In Arabic, all the words, they are gendered. There is no non-gendered word. Okay? How do you understand it from English? For example, this table, it does not have any gender in English. So, you can refer to the table, it. It is big. It is a small. In Arabic, we cannot do that. In Arabic, every word has to have a gender. So if tawila is a feminine, then we say hiya. If we want to say that the table is big, we say hiya kabira. Hiya kabira. If you say that the book is on the table, you say huwa alal maktab or huwa alal tawila. So you are treating book and the table as gendered word, male or female. So remember that huwa or hiya is not only for human beings, but also for non-human beings. Okay. Then, I think we should go to lesson number 5. Right?
4A,
okay. Okay, so in lesson 4A, sister, please tell what did we learn?
The prepositions from, and
ila.
Ila, to.
Meaning to, yes. So we learned 2 more prepositions. So if you just now keep adding up and do not forget the previous, right? So what previous prepositions did we learn? What? And? Allah, very good, very good. Fi and Allah, right? And keep always their meanings also intact in your mind. Then in this lesson, we learn 2 more, ila and min. So min means?
From.
Ila means? To. As you say, I went from masjid to my house, right? Or from my home, I came to masjid. Min and ila. Then, we also learn 2 more pronouns. What? These 2 more pronouns.
Anta.
Very good. Ana means I. Anta. You. Very good.
Masculine.
And can you remind us again the previous pronoun that we learned in the previous lesson?
Hua, hiya.
Very good. Mashallah. So now you keep adding up, right? Hua, hiya, then ana and anta. Then, what else we learned? So, how do you define grammatically? What is the name of Zahaba and Kharaja? Yes, verb. Very good. So, we are, you know, learning nouns, we are learning pronouns, we are also learning verbs. So, Zahaba and Kharaja, these are 2 verbs. Zahaba means? And Kharaja means? He went out. Very good. Like left. Okay. MashaAllah. Then, we go lesson number 5. Brother Kanishka.
Al-Idafa.
Al-Idafa. Do you all remember this relationship? Construct phrase. It is called construct phrase. Can you give an example, Brother Kanishka?
Kitabu Bilalin.
Kitabu Bilalin, yes. You can make your own examples. So it will be more relevant, right?
Sayaratu Amr.
Sayyaratu Umar, yes. The car of Umar.
Baytullah.
Baytullah, the house of Allah, very good. And remember, it's very easy to recognize this relationship. Whenever you will translate in English, you will use of. Right? Or in English we have another way to add S with apostrophe, yes. So, if you want to say that Umar's car, so either you say Umar's car in this way or car of Umar. Right?
No.
In Arabic, it will be same. Sayyaratu Umar. Right? So, you can recognize easily this construction that is called idafa. Then we have some grammar over here. Some grammar involved in this idafa relation. What is the name of the first noun?
Mudaf.
So everyone remembers it?
Mm-hmm.
What is the name of the second noun?
Mudaf
ilay. So what is the rule about Mudaf, Bilal Kanishka?
It can have al.
Yes.
It doesn't
have tanween.
Very good.
Yeah.
So there are some restrictions on Mudaf. And these restrictions are that you do not have al and you do not have tanween. So, Sayyaratu, you always put only one vowel.
Mm-hmm.
It cannot be Sayyaratun Umar.
Mm-hmm.
And also, it cannot be As Sayyaratu Umar.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Then, what are the rules for Mudafilay?
Majroor.
This Mudafilay will always be Majroor.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot bring Dhamma or Fatha over here. But let me tell you about this name Umar. Umar also belongs to the same category, Mamnu min as-sarf. It cannot take kasra. So in this case, you will say Umara.
Mm-hmm.
So whenever there is a kasra, whenever you need a kasra, you replace kasra with fatha in those special nouns. However, if you say Sayyaratu Khalid, so Khalid can take tanween and kasra, everything.
Mm-hmm.
So then you say Sayyaratu Khalidin. In your book, they give the example of Kitabu Bilalin, right?
Okay.
So, yeah, but it's very important Arabic grammar and basic, very important, and many people, they make mistake in this idafa relation if they do not know the rule.
Ibrahim also.
Okay, Ibrahim also belongs the same category of Umar. So, you cannot say Ibrahimi, you say Ibrahima.
Is there a specific reason for that or is that the rule?
Yes, when inshallah we will go in detail, you will learn the reasons also. Okay. Allah says, make the Maqam Ibrahim the place for prayer when you go Umrah and Tawaf, right? After each Tawaf, make 2 rakat nafal. So he says in the Quran, وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَا مُسَلَّى مَقَامِ Ibrahima. He did not say Maqami Ibrahimi. However, Maqam and Ibrahim, they have idafa relation.
Okay.
The station of Ibrahim.
Okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. So, this is one. Yes, Brother Kanishka, what the number two thing that we learned there?
Tahta.
And also, I think we learned Kitabu Man. About
Kitabu
Man.
Oh, sorry, yeah.
Man means whose. So Kitabu Man?
Whose book.
Then Tahta. Okay. So Tahta means?
Under.
Okay, why did they bring Tahta in this discussion? Because Tahta is always Mudaf. Whenever you will use Tahta in any sentence, it will be Mudaf. So, it is obvious that the following noun after tahta will be mudafilay. And if that noun is mudafilay, then grammatically it has kasra.
Okay.
So, you say that under the table. If you put your bag under the table, So you will say al-haqiba. Haqiba is bag. Tahta al-tawilati. Tahta al-tawilati. Or tahta al-maktabi. Under the desk. Okay. Then what is the last thing, Brother Pratishka?
Ya.
About ya. Ya grammatically called vocative particle. Okay, vocative, vocal. Why? Because it's very common in Arabic. Whenever you address someone, you call that person with ya. It is attention getting particle. Okay, it's very common in Arabic, and we do not have this in other languages. But if I call you, if I want to address you, I will say ya Omar. If you want to address me, you will say ya Ustad, right? And we have some rules for this. Okay. So what was the grammar, Brother Kanishka?
The noun following has only one dhamma.
Yes. If there is only one noun, that should have dhamma. So you say ya ustazu. You cannot say ya ustaza. Or ya shaykhu, ya imamu, ya bilalu. You cannot bring tanween after ya. So you cannot say ya shaykhun, ya bilalun. Ya Ustad, no. With only one Dhamma. Okay, this is one situation. The other situation is that there could be Mudaf Mudaf Ilay after Ya. For example, if someone's name is Abdullah, right? So Abdullah already has Idafa relation. What is the meaning of Abdullah?
Slave of Allah.
So whenever you say of, it is idafa. So if you put ya before Abdullah, what is the grammar word then at that time? You will give fatha to mudaf. Then you say ya Abdullah.
Okay.
Ya Abdullah. We cannot say ya Abdullah.
Okay? Ya Abdullah.
Ya Abdullah. Write down this note. It is very important rule.
And then it's gonna be still he, ya Abdullahi or ya Abdullaha?
No, ya Abdullahi, because Allah is mudafilah.
Yeah, okay.
So that mudafilah will follow its own rule.
Okay.
Right? Hmm. But the only change because of ya will be on mudaf. If you want to say, oh the son of so and so, oh the son of Khalid, okay, and you are calling, so how do you call, oh son of Khalid?
Ya Ibna. Khalidin.
Very good. Ya Ibna Khalidin. You will not say Ya Ibnu Khalidin. Okay? If you want to say, call some girl, oh, the daughter of Fatima. Oh, Fatima's daughter. How do you say in Arabic? Very good. Ya Binta Fatima. So now we go lesson number 6. Brother Hassan, again it's your chance. Lesson number 6. What did we do? 6 is Sitta. Okay, feminine.
Masculine with Tamar Bhutam. Adding Tamar Bhutam.
Okay, first thing was Hadihi. Feminine of Hada. And then Tamar Bhutam. So can you explain more about Tamar Bhutam? It says nouns and adjectives are made
feminine by adding a tamar buta at the end.
So most of masculine, and also please now remember the Arabic terminology. Masculine, feminine, we say it only, that is English word. In Arabic, masculine we say muzakkar. Yes, remember this word. Muzakkar. And feminine is mu'annas. Mu'annas. So now most of the time I will refer these two, mudakkar and mu'annas. So it is a common rule in Arabic that whenever we want to change from mudakkar to mu'annas, we add tamar bhuta. For example, a male teacher is in Arabic what? Mudarris. Could be mu'allim, mudarris, same thing, ustaz. Now you want to say female teacher, So what do you do in Mudarris?
Mudarrisa.
Mudarrisa.
Muallim?
Muallima.
Ustaz?
Ustaz.
Very good. Doctor, for example, physician? Tabib?
Tabib.
Even your student, male student is? Talib.
Talib.
Changes to Fatah.
Changes to Fatha before Tamar Huta. Before Tamar Huta, yes. Okay, what else did we learn?
The leap preposition.
Okay, before that, they also said that certain nouns have a separate form for feminine. Yes, this rule, Tamar Huta rule, does not apply 100%. There are exceptions. For example, the word Ibnun and Bintun. Ibnun is boy, son, bintun is daughter. So you do not say ibnatun, right? When you say bintun, so the alif from the beginning is gone. And in the word bintun, there is no tamarbuta, instead there is long ta, flat ta. Right? So this is an exception. Same exception in the word akh and ukht. Akhun is brother, ukhtun is a sister. So we have two changes in Ukhtun. What are these two changes? Please tell me.
We change the alif from A to U.
Yes.
And Khun to Akh. And then we added the flat ta.
Yeah.
Ukhtun.
Yes. Ta tawila, not ta marbuta. Okay. Right?
Yes. Long
ta. Okay. Now, so you said that we also learned li preposition in that lesson. We are on page number 14. So if you see number 3, that is li. So whenever you want to say this thing belongs to, then you bring li. Hada li bilalin. This book is for Bilal. Wadhalika li hamidin. That is for Hamid. Alhamdulillahi. I give you the example, right? Then, also we learned the use of li with man. We already learned man. Whose? Liman. Here is belonging to whom or whose. Without li, only man will be who. Yes. So, liman il kitab. To whom belongs the book. They also told that man becomes mani with kasra when followed by al. So if there is alif lam after man, so you will connect man with alif lam with the kasra. And you saw this example in limanil kitab. Right? We do not say liman al kitab. Got it? No. Okay. Let me write it here. So first we learn liman. What is the meaning of that?
Whose,
right? Now you want to ask whose book, right? So then you say al-kitab. So, you know, you should read liman separate, al-kitab separate. But this is not the way. You are allowed to bring a kasra underneath of noon and the sukoon is gone. Then you say limanil kitab. Okay? So you saw the change? So, and here is another grammar involved. I will explain to you why do we do that. Okay? In limanil kitab. If we go back to the previous position, we have a sukoon on noon, right? Yes. So we have already one sukoon here. Then we have sukoon on lam. Two sukoon cannot be together in Arabic. Side by side or in front of each other. It is not allowed. you can write this, you know, as a rule, that two sukoon cannot be together.
Okay.
So we have to give a vowel to the first one in order to avoid the situation. It's like a traffic jam, right? So if the traffic jam, you have to move one car to make the room for you. So what is the grammar if this is the situation that two sukoons are there? So we call it in Arabic grammar, إِذَا أَسَّاكِنْ إِذَا حُرِّكَ حُرِّكَ بِالْكَسْرِ. Whenever a sakin will be given any vowel, it will be given the vowel only kasra.
Kasra.
So that's why you cannot say fatha on noon. You cannot say limanal or limanul.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be kasra.
Yes.
Limanil kitab. Very good. So we learned this. And the last thing, two more things. Sister side.
Aydan.
Aydan.